If we do follow the health protocols, the ability of people to move around will likely contribute better to growth.
The greatest disruptor of all time is actually COVID-19. Because of limited mobility, people are also not being able to go to physical branches, etc. So it further accelerated the adoption of consumers of digital channels. We are now being able to provide the services needed by our citizens, by our consumers.
Good morning, I'm Rain Musneep. Here are the stories that made it to ANC's rundown. The camp of leading presidential bet Bongbong Marcos pushing for the dismissal of disqualification cases against him before the Supreme Court once he is proclaimed president. International observers say the Philippines' May 9 polls failed to meet the criteria for free and fair elections. And the U.S. Congress approves a $40 billion aid package for Ukraine. The camp of leading presidential candidate Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos's juniors will push through for the dismissal of the pending disqualification and candidacy cancellation cases against him before the Supreme Court once he's proclaimed president. That's as Marcos's counsel, Estelito Mendoza, asserts the High Court does not have the jurisdiction to stop the canvassing of votes for the presidential race and the proclamation of the winner. Mendoza even claims the temporary restraining order plea of the petitions has already been denied. The SC, however, has yet to publicly release a ruling of any sort.
There is no provision whereby the Supreme Court can intervene on that issue at this point in time. Perhaps that will have to come when after the proclamation and the petitioners will then have to decide whether to abide and stick by their petition as filed by the Supreme Court, or whether the scenario has changed and that therefore what they should be filing is an election protest before the Supreme Court, either a quo warranto or an ordinary election protest. We have an electoral presidential tribunal which is vested with that jurisdiction.
So far, what the Supreme Court has issued is a statement asking the Marcos camp, as well as the Election Commission and Congress, to comment within 15 days on the petition for certiorari and TRO filed by civic leaders. The group sought to overturn the ruling of the poll body, which junked their plea to cancel Marcos's certificate of candidacy. A political analyst believes the Supreme Court will not issue a temporary restraining order on the canvassing of votes in the presidential race. But attorney Pacifico Agabin, former dean of the UP College of Law, disagrees with Marcos's lawyer. The Supreme Court does not have jurisdiction to stop the canvassing of votes.
Poll has been expressed in an overwhelming way. So I suppose that in the interest of majoritarian democracy, the Supreme Court will not issue a TRO.
Despite moves to suspend the canvassing of votes for the president and vice president, Congress is now making final preparations for the scheduled tallying on Monday. Zandro Chona reports.
Where the ballot boxes containing the ERs will be stored.
For the first time in 35 years, the plenary hall of the House of Representatives was renovated in time for the canvassing on Monday for the presidential and vice presidential votes. Security around the Batasang Pambansa has been tightened. Strict health protocols are being observed. House Secretary General Mark Mendoza said it's all systems go for Tuesday's canvassing.
Ready na tayo, ready na yung house ano, sa canvassing next week. The meeting yesterday naman was a briefing lang yung team sa mga members natin, no? Members ng canvassing committee ng part ng house.
Seven members from each Houses of Congress who compose the Senate and the House of Representatives contingent to the canvassing with equal number of alternates if any of the members will miss the joint session. Since the election returns and certificates of canvass are digital, canvassing is expected to be quick.
99.88% yata nung validation o nung pag-check nila, comparing it with the digital transmissions were actually accurate, no? So I think this election has been very transparent. Technology has helped us a lot, and participation of the people has been an all-time high. So We will give due course naman with what the people wanted, who they voted for.
Members also give the assurance all sides will be heard during the canvassing.
I think well represented naman ang lahat-lahat. If we have issues, I think it's more on, if it's more on the returns, then that will be entertained. Pero mga issues kasi baka isama, no? Pero I think we will stick to the canvassing lang.
Senate Majority Leader Juan Miguel Zubiri assures there will be a new Senate leader by June 30 to prevent instability and a constitutional crisis if the canvassing is stopped. The Supreme Court en banc is currently on recess and will resume on June 14. On Thursday, the SC has asked the Marcos's camp, COMELEC, Senate, and the House of Representatives to comment on the petition to cancel Marcos's COC. COMELEC says they will comply and will file their comment accordingly. The lawyer for the civic leaders who filed the petition hope the High Court will resolve the issue expeditiously since it involves public interest. The canvassing is expected to be over in 3 days and the new president and vice president proclaimed by May 27. Zandro Ochona, ABS-CBN News.
The International Coalition for Human Rights in the Philippines says the country's May 9 polls failed to meet the criteria for free and fair elections. The ICHRP, along with other groups that made up the International Observer Mission, cited incidents of political killings, large-scale red tagging, and various forms of vote buying throughout the election campaign season until the day ballots were cast. The IOM said their local partner, Contradaya, received around 9,000 election complaints, nearly half of which have already been verified. The group also blasted the vote counting machine glitches, which they say rocked the confidence of the public on the outcome of the elections.
The last Philippine election was marred by widespread irregularities and violence, which undermined the democratic process. The elections took place in the most repressive context since the time of Dictator Marcos.
It is actually difficult for voters to be confident in election proceedings marred by machine errors and breakdowns, as these cast doubt on the capacity of the machine to count their votes.
But Malacañang just brushed off these criticisms, insisting the elections were clean and fair. Acting presidential spokesperson Martin Andanar says they will leave it to the Philippine Election Commission to disprove the allegations. The poll body expects to proclaim all the winning party-list groups on May 25. More COMELEC updates from RG Cruz.
Good afternoon, friends from the media.
The poll body reminds all 2022 election candidates, win or lose, they have until June 8 to file their statement of contributions and expenses. That's 30 days after the elections. A poll body spokesman says Republic Act 7166 requires this before winners can assume office on June 30. Those who fail to file face a fine of up to 30,000 pesos for the first time and 60,000 pesos for the second or subsequent time. That's aside from perpetual disqualification from office for repeat offenders. The disclosure must also be accurate, as it will be examined since the SOSE is a notarized document, so lying in the SOSE can mean perjury. Those who exceed expenditure limits also face jail. The limit is 10 pesos per voter for presidential and VP candidates, 3 pesos per voter for other candidates. The amount goes up to 5 pesos per voter for independent candidates. Political parties can spend 5 pesos per voter.
They really have to submit, and we really have to give proof that they had complied with the law. Higit po sa pagiging compliant sa batas, ito po ay pagtalima ninyo sa ating mga politiko, lalong-lalo na kayong nanalong mga politiko, pagtalima po ito ninyo sa obligasyon ninyo sa bayan. Ipakita po ninyo kayo ay compliant.
The COMELEC and bank will resume its work as the National Board of Canvassers for the party-list elections after the May 24 special elections in Tubaran, Lanao del Sur. But they may no longer wait for the results from Shanghai, China, which has yet to hold elections because of the pandemic lockdown. The COMELEC projects that results in Lanao del Sur, which has over 685,000 voters, will make the 1,991 voters from Shanghai irrelevant to the party-list races. In the latest Canvas report, 6 party list groups already have 1 guaranteed seat because they have about 2% of the total party list vote so far.
We are confident na baka naman yung 1,991 upon completion of Lanao del Sur ay hindi na makakaapekto, and then we could proceed hopefully on May 25 with the proclamation of the winning party list candidates complete na po. Anything is possible. Although we're confident na yung pong Lanao del Sur matatapos naman natin, so it's really not an issue. Yung Shanghai na lang po. We really hope na yung 1,991 will not affect. But if the 1,991 will really be a factor, ang tingin naman po namin nasa bottom part yan. Sa bottom part. But again, projections are positive that it will not really affect.
12 verified complaints docketed and lodged at the COMELEC Law Department. In the meantime, the COMELEC Task Force Contra Bigay has close to 1,000 messages on its Facebook page on vote buying. 167 have been received via email. 88 are valid. 88 are valid reports, but only 49 have evidence. At the COMELEC Law Department, there are 73 reports. 50 have been acted upon, including those in viral videos. Only 12 have ripened into verified complaints at the Law Department. COMELEC appeals for complaints with evidence so these can go straight to prosecution, as mere tips would require further investigation first.
Ito po yung paulit-ulit naming hinihiling sa ating mga kababayan, kung kayo po ay magbibigay sa amin ng informasyon, hiling po sana namin kung maaari gawin na po ito through an affidavit complaint para maikasa na po kagad yung preliminary investigation.
In its latest statistical report, voter turnout is at 83.11%, making it still the best voter turnout in history. The 2022 polls also supposedly has the lowest incidence of violence, just 27 since the election period began. Over 10,000 weapons have been confiscated under the gun ban, which will last until June 8. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
Health experts see a possible spike in infections brought about by the Omicron subvariant, especially in areas with low vaccination rates. Rafael Bosano reports.
Even if the local chief executive of Iloilo City has reported that the three individuals found to have been infected by the BA.2.12.1 Omicron sublineage are now negative for the disease, utmost caution must still be exercised by the public. That's according to the Philippine College of Physicians.
Ang problem kasi diyan will be yung mga taong na-expose.
Okay.
No? So, kasi doon during the time na ginawa yan, maaaring patapos na yung, yung infection.
Okay.
So, but it doesn't mean na hindi siya nagkalat sa iba. I-expect natin by this time, yung contact tracing na yan ay well-established na sa lahat ng mga LGUs natin.
Dr. Limpin says they are now looking at data to determine if there is a rise in hospital admissions as well as the condition of infected patients.
At least mga 2 or 3 doctors yung nagsabi no, may mga intubated ngayon. At kadalasan yung mga intubated, ito yung mga immunocompromised. No? So nananawagan ho kami sa ating kababayan, kung ayaw ho natin magkaroon tayo ng severe COVID, ano,
okay,
na siyang nagiging dahilan ng pagkamatay ng mga tao, tayo po ay kumuha ng ating booster shots.
Infectious disease specialist Dr. Ronjin Solante agrees. If a person is already vaccinated, boosted, and has no underlying conditions, the chances of severe disease is low. But he is quick to point out a possible rise in new infections remains a possibility, especially in areas with low vaccination rates.
It's more transmissible than the original Omicron variant. Now, if this will occur in a population, especially in regions na talagang mababa ang vaccination rate, siguro mas mahigitan pa natin ang mga 500 na nakikita natin before, no? And that's what we are going to monitor.
Fortunately, doctors say current numbers, especially that of hospital utilization rates, are not alarming compared to previous experiences with other variants of concern. However, the public is still encouraged to strictly follow measures that work against preventing transmission or getting severe disease. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.
Over in China, Shanghai residents get a taste of freedom as the city's COVID situation continues to improve. On Thursday, residents in several districts were allowed to shop for groceries for the first time in nearly 2 months. Until now, lockdown families have relied on government food provisions. More businesses have also reopened, although public transportation remains shut. The commercial hub of 25 million recorded no new infections outside quarantine areas for a fifth day in a row, further cementing its zero COVID status. Authorities plan to gradually ease the 7-week-long lockdown in the financial hub starting June 1st. Italy and Sweden report their first cases of monkeypox, joining a number of other European and North American nations that have detected the disease. Rome's Infectious Disease Institute says monkeypox was identified in a young adult who recently returned from the Canary Islands. 2 other cases are also being investigated. Sweden's public health agency also confirms 1 case of the disease, but they are still investigating where the person was infected. Cases of monkeypox have also been detected in Spain, Portugal, Britain, and the U.S. and Canada. Endemic in parts of Western Africa, monkeypox is a viral disease from which most people will recover within several weeks, but it can be fatal in rare cases. Now we're taking a quick break. Still to come, the U.S. Congress approves a nearly $40 billion military and humanitarian aid package for Ukraine. That's next on The Rundown. Stay tuned.
Mobility will be key to recovery because we have relaxed some of our quarantine methods now, and we have allowed more transportation to come out. That's going to prove to be better for demand. If we do follow the health protocols, the ability of people to move around will likely contribute better to growth.
Welcome back. The regional wage boards of Ilocos, Cagayan Valley, and Caraga have approved an increase in the daily minimum wage of workers. In Ilocos, an increase of between 60 and 90 pesos was approved in 2 to 3 tranches. This will raise the minimum wage range in Ilocos to 372 to 400 pesos. Cagayan Valley's wage board also approved a 50 to 75 peso wage hike, bringing the region's minimum wage rate to up to 420 pesos. The wage board in Caraga, meanwhile, agreed to a 30 peso wage hike, raising the monthly minimum rate to 350 pesos. The orders will be submitted to the National Wages Productivity Commission for review and will take effect 15 days after publication in the newspaper of regional circulation. More news overseas now. The U.S. Congress approves a nearly $40 billion military and humanitarian aid package for Ukraine. The bill, previously passed by the House of Representatives, hurdled the Senate by an overwhelming 86 to 11 vote. It now heads to President Joe Biden's desk for his signature. The latest aid package brings the total U.S. assistance to Ukraine to more than $50 billion since Russia began its invasion in February. Meanwhile, the Group of Seven has agreed to provide $18.4 billion to help Ukraine's recovery efforts. More pledges also came Thursday as the U.S. authorized $100 million in additional U.S. arms, equipment, and supplies for Kyiv. Sri Lanka defaults on its debt for the first time in its history as the country struggles with its worst financial crisis in more than 70 years. A 30-day period to repay $78 million of unpaid debt interest expired on Wednesday. The governor of the central bank said the country is now in a preemptive default. Sri Lanka's economy has been hit hard by the pandemic, rising energy prices, and populist tax cuts. A chronic shortage of foreign currency and soaring inflation had led to a severe shortage of medicines, fuel, and other essentials. Sri Lanka has declared a holiday for schools and urged government employees not to report for work due to the prevailing fuel shortage in the country. But Prime Minister Ranil Wickremesinghe has indicated the fuel crisis may ease during the weekend. On to sports now. The Philippines pockets nine-ball gold in the 31st Southeast Asian Games. Johan Chua earned the top prize in the All-Filipino Finals. But as Dayan Castillejo tells us, it was Filipino billiards legend Efren Bata Reyes who was getting all the love in Hanoi.
Billiards is one of the most popular sports in Vietnam. At the Southeast Asian Games, the billiards venue is usually packed and every shot applauded. In the All-Filipino final game between Johan Chua and U.S. Open champion Carlo Biado, Vietnamese fans cheered for both players. Chua ended up the champion, upsetting the favorite, Biado. They added gold and silver medals for the Philippines.
Sobrang di ko po talaga mapigil yung kaba dahil nga talaga ito yung unang pinangarap namin ng dad ko po na mapanalunan. Talagang kanina, talagang every chance po na meron na may chance, binibigay ko talaga yung best ko.
But clearly, the star of the Southeast Asian Games billiards competition is the magician, Efren Bata Reyes. At 67 years old, Reyes is the oldest player in the SEA Games. He has been receiving rock star status at the venue. In the one carom single semifinals, which he lost, he was still loudly cheered by the Vietnamese crowd. Even if his opponent was from Vietnam, the respect and honor for Bata was definitely there. Organizers had to add security whenever he moved around the venue because of the supporters who crowded him.
Hindi ko alam, napapanood pa nila pala ako sa YouTube. At alas, tapos pinakikita nga share ko nila, bumuksan sa, we here? At yung mga security, gusto mo po, lahat sila pa-picture din.
Bata was constantly requested for interviews, signatures, and photos by fans. This one fan even drew a portrait of Bata and was determined to have his billiard idol sign it.
Can you give a sign for me, for me? Is it picture? Yeah.
Although he beat Efren, his opponent was all praises for his billiard hero. The Vietnamese opponent was 40 years younger.
He is very excited when we meet the magician at the legends of the billiards.
Reyes settled for the bronze, but he will surely leave Vietnam a winner. Diane Castillejo, ABS-CBN News, Hanoi, Vietnam.
And that's the rundown. I'm Rain Musngi. We'll be back with more news at 11. Keep it here on ANC.
Mobility will be key to recover.